sorry. Sorry, I can't. Not yet. Sorry.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritus Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Deus auditorium meu intende. Domine ad adiuvando me testina. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritus Sancto. Amen. Sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Right, fellas. Load.
Now I know where to join for life, Cooper.
A meal in a monastery is a bit papist for my Methodist tastes, dear Major.
The abbot is a Cistercian, but civilized for all that.
Toast. Death to the French.
Death to the French.
Death to the French.
Why do you not drink?
I never liked that toast, Major. I am a soldier, not an assassin.
Another toast, then. A safe journey to Torre Castro.
Torre Castro.
Torre Castro.
Will you not laugh if I tell you a story about Torre Castro, dear Miss Parker?
I love stories.
You have the soul of a Spaniard.
Excuse me. Duty calls. I must see to the sentries. Excuse me, ladies.
When will you find me? Says the bells of old Bailey. When I grow rich, says the bells of Shoreditch. When will that... Oh, blimey!
Shh! Is that you in the dresser?
Nice.
Give me a picklock, Cooper.
Picklock, sir? Catch me with a picklock?
They're dead, Coop. But when you got out of Newgate Prison, you got another set. That's the one the officer wants.
Come on.
Do I get it back, sir?
Trust me.
It's very hard to trust a man who wants to borrow a picklock, sir.
So, you could not wait until Torre Castro. Very well, you shall hear the story. 1,000 years ago, the Muslims swept across Spain on their way to Rome. My ancestors made a stand in these mountains, at a hard rock we call Torre Castro. They were many, We were few. We died hard. At sunset, my ancestor, dying, called on Santiago, St. James, the saint of Spain. Santiago came. He came with a banner of blood and a bright sword and slew the invaders in their thousands. And we dipped his banner in the blood and cried out, Santiago, child of thunder, child of battle. The Gonfalon, the banner of blood, kept in my family for 1,000 years, lest we needed Santiago to keep his promise.
What promise, Major?
His promise that he would come again if Spain were invaded, as soon as we raise his banner over the chapel of Torre Castro.
Get to the point, Major.
There's only a small French garrison in Torre Castro. The people of the town know the legend, secretly believe it. As soon as we raise the banner over the little chapel, the people will rise up against the French invader.
Rise up? For a rag on a pole? Are you mad, Major?
No, it's a legend, Mr. Sharpe, and the people believe in it.
As soon as the Gonfalon is unfurled, Santiago will surely come with fire and sword. But it takes time to raise the banner, and before it is unfurled...
The French will come with the saber.
Exactly. That's why we need you. Will you help us fight off the French long enough to raise the banner?
You lied to us, Major. And you, miss. You picked us up, and we marched with you. Fought for you. And for what? For a stupid superstition. For a rag in a bag.
Not a rag, but the last flag of Spain.
Be damned to you and your rag, sir. My rifles march at dawn. South, sir. Good night, miss.
Lieutenant Sharpe. Surprised to see me, Richard. Oh, you've done a grand job. But now, at dawn tomorrow, with the help of my agent, Commandante Teresa, whom I believe you're already met, I want you to seize the chapel of Torre Castro and hold it against all comers until Major Vivar has raised the Gonfalon of Santiago over the chapel roof.
Seize Torre Castro? With 6 men and a straggle of Spaniards? Can't be done. May I remind you of our main mission, sir? To find a missing gentleman?
Not now, Richard. Our mission is Torre Castro. Spain is a sleeping tiger. If the people of Torre Castro rise up, even for an hour, the shock will shake the whole of Spain. Carry on, sir.
Rise up? Do you really believe men will fight and die for a rag and a pole, sir?
You do, Richard. You do.